Once again, thank you so much for having us here at Sunland Village East for our first of our summer concert series. This is the Chandler Gilbert Community College Summer Community Band. We've grown by leaps and bounds since I took over this organization. This is my fifth year with them. We moved up from about 35 members in 2015 to 65 members today. So it's an exciting time to be part of. We have a wonderful program for you this evening, but first we'd like to start with our nation's national anthem. If you'd please rise and remove your hat. This evening. First on our program is a piece by E.E. Bagley, very famous, and it is known as National Emblem. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
You may remember the name George Gershwin. He wrote a great piece called Strike Up the Band. I'll review that one next. It's impossible to feel anything but joy, right? Great stuff, so much fun. We have a new to us. There's a great composer in the band world, his name is James Curnow, and he's written a lot of great band music. This one we particularly became fond of. It's known as Capriccio and Cavatina. We'll play that for you next.
Thank you.
Band music is awesome. A few years ago, I was attending a master's degree program in Oregon, and one of the great band composers of our time is a guy named Dave Holsinger. I don't have any of his music for you tonight, unfortunately, but he made a very prophetic statement. He said, you know, people aren't really writing stuff for orchestras anymore outside of the world of movies and video games and things like that. They're still important, and there's still a lot of music for them, but the ensemble of the future is the concert band. Because that's what all the schools are doing, and now there are starting to be maybe a little bit of a surge in movies that are having band music in them, and everybody wants to see a marching band and all that stuff. So I think the future of band is actually very bright. I think I'm excited about that. I hope you are too. So how many of you are familiar with Stephen Sondheim? Okay, remember Send in the Clowns? We've got a neat arrangement of Send in the Clowns for you next.
Thank you.
So this year, many of you probably are aware, is the 75th anniversary of D-Day. And I had the great honor to be part of a wind ensemble performing over there for that event. It was something else to be in France on June 6th this year, let me tell you. The band I was part of is actually, it was a group here in Tempe called Music Celebrations International that puts together international performing tours for groups like that. And the conductor of our band was a 94-year-old veteran of D-Day, who had actually come ashore in the first wave at Omaha as a machine gunner and survived, and later went on to a degree in music and then a 36-year career in the Air Force, where he was director of the Washington Band for 21 years. So what an honor. I mean, wow, there's just no words to it. I want to thank my band as well for putting up with this trip because, I missed two rehearsals with them. And they were just so gracious to not give me a hard time about being able to do that. So I want to thank them for their support. We'll start reminiscing a little bit now in our concert, given that this is such an important year in history. And we'll play a little music from Glenn Miller. Sound okay?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So we're about to take a short intermission, but before we do, we want to wish a very special happy birthday to somebody in our band who has been a band director for many, many years. In fact, he was my brother's band director when my brother was in junior high school. His name is Larry Badke, and we're all going to sing happy birthday. Are you ready?
Yeah. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
We also have a special ensemble that's going to stand out here and play for you a little bit of Zydeco music. So enjoy that. We'll be back for the full band at about, let's say, 15 minutes from now. Okay.
Here you go, Zydeco.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody. We'll start the second half of our concert with one of my favorite Sousa marches. You may or may not be familiar with it. It's called Anchor and Star. And Sousa wrote a lot of marches, as you know, like 130 some odd marches. And as luck would have it, he's been dead a long time, and all of his music is now in the public domain. So the United States Marine Corps has gotten a hold of all the old scores, and they have reprinted everything in full size. Because for band people, looking at parts that were not this big, that's our whole life for years was on these little flip holder things, which everything is really tight and short, and if you didn't have good vision, forget it. And we're trying to march and play this stuff. Now the Marines have made it easier, and they put everything online. We can download PDFs for free. So every Sousa march now that he ever wrote is lightning quick to get a hold of. So we've been playing through some of the better marches over this last few seasons, and we will continue to do that. Anyway, we hope you enjoy one of my favorite Sousa marches, Anchor and Star.
Thank you.
one of the things that makes that march particularly unique, you may have noticed, is that the third section, not only does it go on long, but it has so much counterpoint in it. If you listen to, you know, the trumpets start and then the trombones and the baritones added in and finally get the woodwinds, and by the time you're in the middle of that, it's a J.S. Bach level counterpoint going on. It's just incredible stuff. I love it. Hope you liked it too. Another big name in the band world now, is a gentleman named Brian. I can never get his name right. It is Balmage. It looks like Balmages, but it is Balmage. So Brian Balmage, wonderful composer, some very evocative music, and we're going to play a piece of his now called Star Above Shine Brightly.
Thank you.
Capra's Man of La Mancha. Okay, so the play came out back in the day, but the movie was it not Best Picture in 1962? Does anybody remember? 72. It wasn't Best Picture, okay. Oh, okay. Wow, I had Sophia Loren in it, so I made it Best Picture in my mind. So, this piece has a little bit of special significance for me. I actually played it in junior high school at a summer music clinic that I attended. So, we found this in the library and we all enjoy it. So, we'll play that for you next. Man of La Mancha.
Thank you.
classic, another classic of the Broadway stage, Rodgers and Hammerstein's South Pacific, obviously, again, with the World War II theme. We have a really particularly good arrangement here that we're going to do for you of music from South Pacific.
Thank you.
This evening, we would like to make a special recognition. We'd like to recognize Lorraine Mutucky, a Gold Star wife, whose husband Thomas Mutucky of the U.S. Marine Corps was injured on the island of Peleliu in 1944 and passed away in 1980 due to injuries received at that time. So, Lorraine, would you stand and please be recognized? Do we have armed service, current or past, folks in the audience tonight? Anyone at all? Well, we like to recognize you folks for all of the sacrifices you've made for our freedoms, and so we're going to now play the Armed Forces Medley. So when you hear your service song, please do stand and be recognized by the audience. Just about out of music. So is it okay if we play just one more? Yeah. Okay. again, staying with our theme, celebrating World War II and the memories there, you all remember who Bob Hope was, and he was the guy in the USO entertaining the troops during the war. So let's salute Bob Hope as a closer for this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you so much again for having us every summer. We love coming here and we look forward to next year. Thank you again to our villa as well, who helped set everything up ahead of time. You're perfect, round of applause. Have a wonderful summer. We'll see you next year. Yeah.